Hello everyone and welcome back. Here we are with the fifth episode of the Ultimate Hat Trick Tutorial. Today we will speak about the 7 Yacht Academy's golden rules in Hat Trick. Let's go! Why the Yacht Academies are important? Simple. The 17 years old players have a value and you can see it in the market. Just have a look to Victor, 1.3 millions. Alberto, 1.8 millions. Itzvan, 4.3 millions. That means just one thing. Money, that means value, and the market recognizes it. Now, we understood that the young players have value, but let's understand all the reason why you should focus on the Yacht Academies. One of the main pillars is that you can improve the competitiveness of your main team thanks to the Mother Club bonus. You can see in the right the example. Carlo, a new player of my main team, that is with me since a few months, with just 0.3 loyalty bonus in each skill. Malek, an historical player of my team that reached the maximum loyalty bonus for an external player, let me say, that have 1 point for each skill. And Darren, a player from my Yacht Academy that receive a benefit of 1.5 points in each skill thanks to the Mother Club bonus. And this is huge, guys. Second pillar, it's easy but really important. You will make money, and it's too important for the finance of your club. The third pillar, in parallel to the main club management, you can add fun finding the way to complete the skill of the players in the best way possible before the promotion. But how can you complete on time a player before the promotion? Let's see the general training rules. We have as example Mark. We see just his 8 potential of playmaking and 5 actual scoring. Primary training will support us to discover the actual level of playmaking of Mark. Meanwhile, the secondary training can support us to discover the potential skill of scoring. But be careful, you won't be able to do that in the same training, therefore you won't be able to train as primary training playmaking in the same time as secondary training in scoring. You will set passing and we will see it in the next example to understand why. Here you can see the main overview that works also in the main club. Training spots from the goalkeeping to the scoring. You need to keep in mind the 100 training spot also in the Yacht Academies. Let's see why thanks to the Mark example. As first step, we want to discover the actual value of playmaking, putting him as inner midfielder in the 100% playmaking training spot. We cannot set scoring as secondary training. He won't be trained in scoring in the inner midfielder position and will just waste one training. Therefore, we will set passing as secondary training. In this way, we will can understand the passing potential that can be useful. Once discovered the playmaking values, in a second training match, we can put him as forward. In this way, we can set passing as primary skill, and we will discover the actual values of that skill. And we will set as secondary training scoring to discover the scoring potential. That's it, guys. This is the quick example how you can discover skills of a new player. In the previous example, I show you how to discover the skill of a player. Here we can see the training constants. Thanks to the Glinzales info, I will leave you the link in the video description, we can understand how prioritize the training and complete the players before the promotion. Keep in mind that the league matches train at 100%, the friendly match train at 80%, primary training give 100%, meanwhile secondary training give just 60.7%. And if you do a double training with the same skill, you will receive a malus. Therefore, despite a velocity of 166.7 6.7%, you will gain just 133% of max speed. And in the right, you can see example of the trainings combination that you can do. In my case, with Mark, I need to reach 8 playmaking as fast as I can. Training, playmaking will help me, because I will train Mark at 133% each training, and I will push his skill to achieve at 8 in the faster way possible. Now you know how to discover skills, how you can complete the players on time. But meanwhile you are doing it, you need to think. Do you need to improve your team, or are you planning to sell the player? In the first case, your priority will be maximize him in all the skill in yellow, let me say. It means that after the level up, for example, at 7 of passing of Sabatino, I did some training more, making him, 7.5 passing before he become yellow. Therefore, once promoted, he will skill up faster in the main team thanks to the sub-level, gaining more value for your club. Meanwhile, if you need to just sell the player, the main important thing is level up all the skill, making him complete for the market. Therefore, it's okay keep the green skill without maximizing the sub-level. If I have other players to prioritize, I can focus on them, because I already reached 7, and the market, for the market, it's okay, I will just sell it, and I don't need for my main team that sub-levels. And finally, here we are. Now you know the main info about the Youth Academy's management, and you can understand in a better way the 7 golden rules. Let's start. First, set up the scouts searching any kind of player. Don't focus only in the role that you are training in your main team. You need to find the best player possible in your region. Don't give limits to your scouts. If the player discovered will be good for your main team, it's okay. If not, you will set at 17 years old, making a lot of money. Second point. Accept mainly 15 years old player. You need to have the time to complete them and promote at 17 years old for two reasons. Reason one, the velocity of the training in the main team is quicker than Youth Academy. Therefore, promote them at 17 years old and train faster in the main club is your priority. Reason two, the players in the market at 17 years old have a huge demand and it means a lot of money. The third point, with the 2024 Atric Rules update, you can stay in bigger leagues without problem. Just remember to set up always friendly match once you see the notification. In this way, you will maximize the training speed and you will have more chance to complete the players. Fourth point, use play creativity to trigger special event during the matches. It's really important. Fifth point, set the midfielder always defensive and the forwards always normal. You will have more chance to trigger powerful events. Sixth point, with the 2024 Atric Rules update, sometimes the scout will reveal you since the beginning if a player is a no specialty one. Decline them and don't lose time. Seventh, focus on the core player. It's really difficult to complete all the players in the Youth Academies in the same time. You need to focus in the main one, with the specialty. Set the plan on the strongest one. The secondary players will benefit from the training, and that's it. Remember that you need to complete the core players within the 17 years old and promote in on time. That's it, guys, for today. If you have any doubts, write question in the comment below. I will create a second video sharing example with my academies and I will reply directly there. So, thank you all and see you in the next video. Ciao, ciao!